LaPorsche, and I'm here with actor slash artist slash producer, man of many talents, Mishon.
Girl, it's nice to see the way that you'll be working hard. Don't nobody really notice you'll be on your job all the time.
So, you just had your first featured role in Frat Brothers. Mm-hmm. And I saw that it got a pretty polar response online. Mm-hmm. Some people liked it, some people didn't like it. Mm-hmm. How did you take the constructive criticism?
I mean, at the end of the day, I'm on television, so.
I feel you.
You know, and I shot that actually. A lot of people, it was their first chance seeing it. That's a movie that I shot over a year and a half ago. Mm-hmm. And it's finally getting its debut, television debut. So, you know, I'm glad that people have their opinions. People are going to always have opinions about everything that anybody does, especially that's in the limelight, especially, you know, something that's presented. But at the end of the day, they're talking about it. So
yeah, and I heard it was like the most tweeted about movie
in most,
BET history?
Yeah.
Nice.
As an artist, I can say my biggest influence is Michael Jackson. I know a lot of people say that.
Yeah.
It might be a cliche thing just because he's inspired and influenced so many people in general, just as a whole. But definitely, I just from a very young age, around like I would say like 9, is when I, you know, just fell in love with his music and the way he captivates his audience and the way he captivates your imagination and just takes you into his world. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? That's definitely something that I value to the highest degree as an artist. So.
Favorite Michael Jackson song? You gotta pick one. You have to pick one.
I have to pick
one? You have to pick one.
Dirty Diana.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
Nice.
And it might come from, you know, me being an artist and experiencing Dirty Diana's in real life. You know, it just comes from such a raw, realistic place. And at the same time, it just paints the perfect picture.
I'm glad you said that. So has Mishon ever had his heart broke?
Have I ever had my heart broke? I would say I've had some disappointments. I would say I'm more the heartbreaker. Unfortunately.
So how did you break into the entertainment industry?
At the age of 9 is when I first got my opportunity to even do music. My cousin started a record label called Dynasty Records.
Who you're still with now.
Yeah, still today. I was 9 years old and got in the studio, started making music, had fun with it. You know, started getting in front of, you know, audiences, kids, and performing at different high schools, and, you know, stuff like that. And it just became something that I love because I've been singing my whole life. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So it just became something that I really was passionate about and took very seriously. And, you know, 10 years later.
Nice.
That's a good question. I like to...
R&B, pop, mixture.
I don't really like to define it, you know what I mean? Because I feel like music nowadays... Yeah, there are genres, but at the same time, I don't really want to be an artist who is kind of stuck, defined by a genre. Like, I just want to give people great music. You know, I listen to all types of music. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I just, you know, I signed up for this, but I didn't just sign up for R&B. I didn't just sign up for hip-hop. I signed up for the world. I signed up for music.
Nice.
You know what I mean? So that's what I do. I give people my perspective of just... life in general, you know what I mean? Because the people who are my age can relate to it, and then the people who are 30, 40, 50 have already been through it.
Yeah.
So it's appreciated that much more, you know what I mean? So I just like to give people, you know, my heart. Yeah. I really wanna work with everybody. Like at the end of the day, it's fun for me, and I like working with people who have the same integrity for the music as I do, and the same integrity for getting that raw, that realness across, and really making music that people are going to gravitate towards. You know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, we spending all this money, we in the studios, spending all this time on the music, and if people don't feel the same thing that I felt when I wrote the record, then what's the point? You know, you got artists like Drake. who kill that, who do that to the nth degree. You got artists like, you know, just you name it. You know what I mean? I definitely just want to work with anybody who has that same integrity as me.
So how do you stay connected with your fans? And what is the name of your fan club for those who don't know?
I call my fans my diamonds. And I stay connected with my fans. I talk to my fans all the time, you know, whether it be via Twitter, Instagram, mainly Twitter and Instagram.
Yeah. And I see you even call some of your fans. I love that. Yeah. Surprise call.
Yeah, why would I not? Because it's like, for me as an artist, if I don't really have a connection to the people who are supporting me, then how are they really feeling, how are they really gonna feel like they're a part of what I got going on?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And at the end of the day, women are the tastemakers for all of this, everything. You know what I mean? So I wanna know what you're thinking. Like I said, you have an amazing perspective.
So would you consider yourself more of a sweetheart or smooth and player type?
Player type? You mean like bunch of women?
Yeah.
I'm a smooth sweetheart.
A smooth sweetheart.
Yeah.
A smooth, y'all, he just said a smooth sweetheart. Those are the worst ones, ladies. Watch out, okay?
I can say I really want my legacy to be, I want people to really be passionate about life. Like, I want people to really love what they're doing. Like, I don't want people to just be robots and just go through the motions. Like, I want you really to just be in this moment, understand what you're doing, why you're doing it. Because once you get to that point, it's like, then you're in control. You know what I mean?
Nice. Describe to me your dream girl. What's wifey? Who's bae? Maybe we shouldn't say bae, just in case you call a different people.
No.
Maybe we shouldn't say bae.
That's not even part of my vernacular.
Like it.
But wifey.
Who's wifey? I want details. How does wifey look?
Wifey understands. Wifey understands.
So, we all know you're a dancer. Mm-hmm. You have to teach me some moves. You have to teach me some moves.
Are you going to receive the moves? Or are you going to, like...
I am going to try. All the people at UGA know I can break it down. Y'all know. LaPorsche gets down. However, you know, I don't know what type of moves he's about to teach me. So, be with me, y'all, and pray for me. Let's go. So we just got done dancing, and Mishon Slick tried to stunt on me. Don't get it twisted, though. I can dance.
Hey, look, you asked for the moves. I gave you the moves. You wasn't ready.
I know. I wasn't ready.
The album. Mm-hmm. The album is called 90-10. A lot of times in relationships, people want to experience a 50-50 kind of thing, but, you know, sometimes it really ends up being more of 90-10. You know what I mean? And sometimes you can give somebody the most of you, you still end up with the short end of the stick.
Mm-hmm.
And that's basically, you know, just me showing my perspective of how things are, and you know, it's just real life, you know what I mean? There's also a philosophy that I kind of been reading into lately too, and it's called the 90-10 rule. So basically 10% of life that happens to you is out of your control, and the other 90% is how you react to it.
Nice.
That creates 100% of your entire reality.
Well, I really enjoy interviewing you. I definitely think that you're an amazing artist, but I can't let you leave without singing something to me.
Okay.
Go ahead, hit me with it.
Good.
Okay. Now, I don't know how you do it, but you do it. They assume that beautiful girls never go through it. By now, anybody else would be ruined. But not you, baby, you just keep it moving. And I know to be out here on your own, girl. I see, baby, yeah. And I know you keep it real when they don't, girl. I feel you, yeah.
Sing, y'all.